In this video, you'll learn how to take your PlayStation 2 with a free McBoot memory card and an internal hard drive installed, and take your original game disc and dump them over to the hard drive so you can play them directly off your hard drive, no disc required. Of course, for this to work, you need a PlayStation 2 with a free McBoot memory card, an internal hard drive, and a USB drive in FAT32 format. If you need to learn how to set all of this up, I have a video linked for you in the pinned comment and description below to guide you on your way. The software used to dump your game disc to your PlayStation 2 hard drive is called HDL Game Installer. I've got a link for this for you in the description below. To get it, scroll down on the website until you get to the link that says download and click it. What you want to do is click on the very first link in the download section. That's going to take you to the MediaFire website, where you can click on this big download button and grab the file that you need. You should have this file in your download folder in 7Z format. You'll need to extract it using a 7Z extractor tool. If you need one, I have one linked for you in the description below. Go ahead and extract the 7Z file into the downloads folder. Then delete the 7Z file when you're done with it to eliminate clutter. You'll have a PC folder and a PS2 folder. Go into the PS2 folder. You'll need to grab two files from inside this folder. One is going to be the Lang folder, because this has the various languages that you need. And then you're going to need the HDLGameInstaller.elf file. Copy both of these files and make absolutely certain that you get both of them. One without the other will not let this process work. With the files copied over, insert your FAT32 formatted USB drive into your computer and navigate to it in File Explorer. Then paste these files directly onto the root of the USB drive. Having a clean USB drive to start with definitely helps make these things easier to find once you put the drive in the PlayStation 2, as you'll find out in a moment. Once the files are copied over to your USB drive, you're done with your PC. You can close out File Explorer and come down and safely eject the USB drive from your computer. Insert it into the number one USB port, usually the most farthest left on your PlayStation 2, and power on your system. If you're getting value from this video, make sure you subscribe while you're here. We have an incredible group of gamers that are part of this community, and you belong here with us. All right, let's get back to it. With your PlayStation 2 booted up to the free McBoot main menu, you'll need to copy the HDL game installer from the USB drive over to your memory card and set it up on the menu. From the main menu of free McBoot, scroll down with the D-pad until you get to Launch Elf, then select it with the X button. Alright, let's zoom in on Launch Elf just a bit to make this easier to see on mobile. The goal here is to move those two files off of the USB drive and put them on your memory card. In this case, I have the memory card with free McBoot in memory card slot number 1, which is the rightmost slot. To get the files transferred over from the USB drive over to the memory card, use the D-pad on the controller to move the red highlight down until you get it centered on Mass. That stands for Mass Storage Drive. Then select Mass with the circle button to continue. Launch Elf has a way of seeing all the hidden files that have pretty much ever been on your USB storage device, Mac and PC both. But the two files you're looking for are still on here. Let's go ahead and get them moved over to the memory card. Use the D-pad to scroll down with the red highlight until you get to the Lang folder. With the Lang folder highlighted, press the right one button, that's the right shoulder button, not the right trigger button, on the controller. Copies should already be highlighted with the arrow, select it with the circle button. This will put the folder in the copy queue. Press the triangle button to go back to the list of storage devices for your PS2 system. Now use the D-pad to scroll up until you get to either memory card 0 or memory card 1, wherever you have the memory card put in. In this case, it's memory card 1. Press the circle button to select your memory card location. Use the D-pad to scroll down and select the apps folder with the circle button. Now you can paste that folder in here. Use the right one or right shoulder button to pull up the advanced options menu. Paste should already be highlighted. Select paste with the circle button to paste that folder in here. This takes a couple of minutes in real time. Now you'll need to go back over to your USB drive and grab the ELF file. Press the triangle button to go back until you get to the list of storage devices, and scroll back down with the D-pad until you get to Mass. Select Mass with the circle button. Use the D-pad to navigate down with the highlight until you get to HDL Game Installer. Then press the right one shoulder button. You'll get the Advanced Options menu with Copy already selected. Press the circle button to copy the file. With the ELF file copied, let's go put it in the same place on the memory card. Press the triangle button to get back to the list of drives. Use the D-pad to navigate up until you get to either memory card 0 or 1, and press the circle button to go into your memory card. Inside the memory card folders, you'll see that apps folder again. Press the D-pad to go down until you get to apps and select it with the circle button. Inside the apps folder, press the right shoulder button on the controller to pull up the advanced menu. It should already have the arrow on paste. Just press the circle button to paste this file into this folder. You can run the program through LaunchElf every time, but I think it's unnecessary. Let me teach you how to put this on your FreeMacBoot main menu. Back all the way out to the main menu of LaunchElf and then power off your PS2. Then power it back on to get to the FreeMacBoot main menu. As you'll see here, just because you copied the ELF file over doesn't mean it magically appears on the menu. You have to go to the configurator in order to make that work. Use the D-pad to scroll down in the FreeMacBoot menu system until you get to the menu selection for FreeMacBoot Configurator. It's probably near the bottom of your list. Then select it with the X button to launch it. You can select to use Circle and X either way that you please here, but just for the sake of consistency, I'd recommend that you press Circle here so that you can use Circle to go forward just like you did in LaunchElf. Alright, let's zoom in just a little bit to make this easier to read on mobile. Use the D-pad to scroll down with the selector pointer until you get to the listing that says Configure OSD-SYS, then select it with the circle button. To add a menu selection for HDL Game Installer, use that same arrow in the D-pad to scroll down one until you get to Configure Item 1. These are going to be the listings that are already on your menu. To find a blank spot that you can use the D-pad to scroll to the right until you get to a number that does not have a menu listing assigned to it. In fact, here's one right here, number 4. Select it with the circle button to go in and edit it. You can name this whatever you want, but I'd recommend naming it HDL Game Installer. Press the circle button on name and then use the alphanumeric on-screen keyboard to type in the name that you wish to have here. Make note here that since it's not shown on screen because of the zoom in, use the square button for space. Then use the D-pad to come down to OK and select it with the circle button. The menu needs to know where to navigate in order to launch the ELF file. Use the D-pad to scroll down to path number 1 and select path number 1 with the circle button. This will let you navigate to the path where you put the HDL Game Installer ELF file, which is going to be on your memory card, so either memory card 0 or memory card 1, select it with the circle button. Use the D-pad to come down to apps, select apps with circle, then use the D-pad to move the highlighter down to HDL Game Installer and select it with the circle button. This will establish the path in the menu system. Use the D-pad to navigate the arrow down to return and select return with the circle button. Then use the D-pad to move the arrow to exit, which is at the bottom, and select it with circle. This is important. Don't overlook this. Use the D-pad to move the arrow to save CNF to either MC0 or MC1, depending on which slot you have your memory card in. Press circle to save the configuration file. You'll get a red message in the top left corner of the screen confirming that you've saved. Then use the D-pad to scroll down to exit and select exit with the circle button to go back to the FreeMacBoot main menu. Back at your FreeMacBoot menu, you'll now have a new listing. Use the D-pad to scroll down until you now see the listing for HDL Game Installer. Cool. Select it with the X button to launch it for the first time. Among the many tricks up its sleeve, HDL Game Installer has network connectivity. However, this PlayStation 2 is not connected to the network. To get to the part where you can just simply install the games directly from the disc, just wait out this message until it says it's not connected to the network. Then you can navigate to OK with the D-pad and select it with the X button to access the main menu of HDL Game Installer. Let's get one of your game discs copied over to your PlayStation 2 hard drive. Go ahead and insert your disc into your PlayStation 2 optical drive. You won't see the name of it pop up here, so don't get thrown off by this. To select the game to install it, press the Start button. You'll need to enter a game name for each of the three listings at the top left of this menu. I'm testing this with the game Corvette, so call me crazy, but I'm actually going to enter the game name Corvette for each of these. Then use the D-pad to scroll down through the other menu choices until you get to Next and select Next with the X button. You'll be asked if you want to proceed. Use the D-pad to scroll down to OK and select it with the X button. You'll be asked for an icon source. You can just use the default here. Use the D-pad to scroll down to OK, press X. Then at the final confirmation for this, come down to OK and select it with X. In real time, this process can take quite a while. In fact, in this case, it took around 12 minutes in real time. But hey, who wants to watch that paint dry? Let's fast forward to the end. Once the disc dump is complete, you can navigate down to OK and select OK with the X button to continue. This will be a reliable process for you to be able to copy your discs over to your hard drive. As you can see, Corvette is now listed in the list of games. But don't bail just yet. Let me show you how to launch this in OPL. To exit out of HDL Game Installer and go back to the main menu for FreeMic Boot, press the circle button on the controller. Then select OK to confirm. Back at the FreeMic Boot main menu, use the D-pad to scroll down through the menu choices until you get to Open PS2 Loader, or it might say OPL on your menu. Select it with the X button to launch it. At the OPL main menu, press the circle button to access the games on your hard drive, and you'll see the list of games that you had there and the new one you copied there. Use the D-pad to select the game you want from the menu and X to launch it, and in no time, you'll be driving the American sports car. For more great PlayStation 2 content, check out this video here. It's shown on screen in the desktop browsing experience and linked in the pinned comment and description below. I'm looking forward to seeing you there in the next video.